We've got another Game 7 coming up on Wednesday. Let's talk about that game, plus Game 2 in Miami and Milwaukee. Michael Bolton.
Let's get to it.
Let's get to it, indeed.
You are Locked On Fantasy Basketball, your daily fantasy basketball podcast, part of the Locked On Podcast Network, your team every day.
Hello and welcome to the Locked On Fantasy Basketball Podcast, brought to you by Basketball Monster. My name is Josh Lloyd and I am the lead fantasy analyst at basketballmonster.com and at Yahoo Sports Australia. And you can find me on Twitter as always at @RedRock_Beeble and on Instagram at Locked On Fantasy Basketball. Today, we are looking at Wednesday's games in the NBA. There are two of them. There's a second round game between the Heat and the Bucks. There's a game seven between the Thunder and the Rockets. So let's start talking about those games now. And we are going to start with the Miami Heat and the Milwaukee Bucks. The Heat got the win in game one, I guess somewhat surprisingly, but the Bucks come in 5-point favorites in this one with a total of 221. Remember, the Bucks lost game one in their round one series against the Magic. Of course, the Heat are a little bit of a different type of opponent, a better opponent, so it's no guarantee that they go on and win the next four here in this one. I still think that the Bucks will win this series, but obviously a huge showing for Miami in game one. If we look at FanDuel pricing here, the Iron Shoulder Goran Dragic is at 6,800. He's consistently putting up big numbers. He's averaging 40 in the last three. He had 43 in game one. 6,800 is too cheap of a price for Dragic. I really like it. For the Bucks, Eric Bledsoe, he's still questionable. He missed game one with a hamstring injury. I wouldn't want to use him regardless, but Georgie Hill at 4,400 will be his backup slash starter if Bledsoe is out. Now, Hill played 36 minutes in game one. He had 11 points. He occasionally will have a decent enough game, but he is nothing that looks to me, even if he starts to be a cash lock, he can still be a tournament guy, but big games from George Hill are few and far between most of the time. At shooting guard, Middleton's at 7,500. That looks like a massively strong play. Big minutes, good production. They're going to get big minutes out of him again. I like that one for mid. While Tyler Hero's at 5,200 just for GPPs. While Jim Butler, fantastic last game.
Because he's my Butler.
Butler at $9,000, dropped 54. They played him 36 minutes. He was a massive factor in why they won. 9,000 is a big price for Butler, no doubt. And yeah, I'd rather the 7,500 for Chris Middleton than 9,000 for Jimmy Butler. But I still think Jim is in play here. I would go with Middleton at that extra $1,500 saving. Iguodala's at 42, Dunk Robinson at 45. Iguodala, no chance. Robinson maybe for tournaments, but even then, not that interesting. Well, Connaughton, Matthews, Korver, DiVincenzo, just no production from those guys. Your small 40s, Yanni Antetokounmpo, he's at 11,500. A disappointing game one, just 44 points. I expect him to bounce back and get close to 60 here. Now, the Heat defense has caused some problems for Yanni. He's averaging just 44 the last three games against Miami in 32 minutes. Prior to that, you know, he's a guy that normally gets 55 to 60 most games. So there is some of that factor there. I still think he's okay. But 11.5 is obviously an expensive price. And with his past record against the Heat, maybe there is some cause for concern. Crowder's at 4,700. I have no real interest in that one. At power forward, Bam Adebayo, $8,000, 45 in game one. He should be a 40-point-ish type guy here, so I think he looks pretty strong. Marvin Williams off the bench, but not doing much. While at center, Brook Lopez at 5,700, love that for cash. I think he's got limited upside, but I absolutely love his floor value at 57. While Kelly Olynyk at 4,000, yeah, not really all that keen on getting involved in the Kelly Olynyk business. On DraftKings, it's similar. Yanni's at 11.4. You know, some value there, but some concern, obviously. Chris Middleton at 8,100 is more expensive, but I still think that's good. I love Lopez, and I love Bam. Dragic is at 6,900.
Giggity!
And that looks okay, while Butler at 83 looks super, super good on DraftKings. A much better DraftKings option than he is over on FanDuel. Let's flip it now. Game two of the night. It's a game seven. It's the Rockets. It's the Thunder. The Thunder won game six to take it to game seven. And the Rockets are 5-point favorites in this game. The total 219.5 points. Will Russell Westbrook be limited again? We don't know that at this point. I would have to assume yes. I have to assume for the sake of Houston winning the game that he is, because he was pretty shithouse in the two games that he's played in terms of shooting efficiency and turnovers and taking the ball out of James Harden's hands. So there is some absolute concern there for the Rockets and Russell Westbrook. Put Chris Paul's at 8,200. He had 50 points in game six. He played 40 minutes. He's getting 40 at night. They're going to need big numbers again from Chris Paul. So I think he's okay at 8,200. Westbrook's at 88, only for a tournament if you want to be really contrarian, but he has not looked good since coming back. Austin Rivers, no. Shooting guard, Gilgeous Alexander's at 7,100. A real stinker of a run from Shea, averaging under 24 points in the last three, just 20 in game six. You get the feeling a good game is going to come, and it's going to be a 37, 39 pointer, but you can't trust it at this point. I think I'd be okay getting back on him here, as I think that he'll be rostered in far fewer lineups. Dennis Schroeder's at 6,000. Not the greatest game, but a lot of minutes and a lot of opportunities. So I think 6,000 looks all right for him. Well, Jimmy Harden's at 11,400. Only 47 in game six. Much like Yanni, those two high-priced guys didn't really get it done for us. And I guess that's somewhat of a concern when we look to the look to how we spend up. Do we spend up on Jim Butler at 9,000, or do we spend up on 11,500 on Yanni and Jimmy Harden? And it is a tough one. Like, which one of these guys is most likely to go off? I think it's probably still Yanni, but Harden is in that mix. I would lean Antetokounmpo, though, most likely. Lu Dort, the minutes are tumbling for Dort because he can't do anything offensively. Just 20 minutes last game at 3,700. He's not really any sort of DFS threat. While Terrence Ferguson and Ben McLemore, they are trying to do as little as possible. 0 points for McLemore in 4 minutes last game. 0.2 points for Terrence Ferguson last game in 5 minutes. They are playing these pointless four-minute stints, and that is it. And that does it for them. At small forward, the Italian cock, Danilo Gallinari.
Hands off my cock!
He's at 5,800. Matt, he was shithouse in game five. Really, really good in game six. The price is extremely low, and if Gallinari plays to his level, he'll smash it. But he's had some really bad games. So I think he's an excellent tournament play, but the reliability is not strong. Bazley at 3,600. I love what Bazley's doing. 22 minutes, 21 points at 3,600. What a great way to be able to fit more high-priced guys in. I like that quite a bit. Well, Eric Gordon continues his strongish run, but at $6,000, didn't quite get it done last game. Just 28 points. I don't mind him, but a $500 price rise probably takes him out of a lot of the situations that he would have been in before. While $5,000 for Dan House, 26 average over the last three, 28 over the last five. That's good cash value. It's limited tournament value, but it's good cash value nonetheless. I'll tell you what else is good cash value, and that is getting yourself a box of the best tasting protein bars money can buy. Built Bar is back, and they're back with new flavors. In addition to their original 12 flavors, which included orange and toffee almond and raspberry, there's six newies: cherry barcia, lemon almond cheesecake, and apple almond crisp. Three of the new flavors you can try at Built Bar, which is the protein bar that tastes just like a candy bar. It's great for someone looking to lose or maintain weight while indulging in a delicious treat. And all bars are covered in 100% chocolate. They're soft and easy to chew. They are low calorie, low sugar, high protein, and high fiber. The cookies and cream bar, for example, 17 grams of protein, 130 calories only, 4 grams of sugar, and 4 grams of net carbs. If you go to builtbar.com and you use our promo code LOCKEDON, one word, you'll get $10 off your next order. So go to builtbar.com and use that promo code LOCKEDON for $10 off your next order. All right, let's go on to the rest of this game now. The power forwards, Bob Covington's at 6,300. He dropped 47 points last game. He is a little bit hit and miss, and that is a $1,000 price rise for Covington. So that takes a little bit of the appeal away, but we know he can get those defensive stats in big, big bunches, and that's what gives him good GPP upside. For your power forwards, other power forwards, Nerlens Noel and Jeff Green.
My name is Jeff.
With Westbrook back, Green's value is tumbling, so hard to get excited about him. And then at center, it's really Steven Adams at 5,500, who's getting minutes but not really doing anything with them. I'm not keen on that. Well, PJ Tucker had a massive game six, his best game in almost the whole bubble. 32 points, but he's up to 4,800 now. I am not for a single second buying PJ Tucker as a guy that's worth almost $5,000. On DraftKings, again, Covington and Gallinari, the upside plays there at 59 and 6100 respectively. Well, Jimmy Harden at 11-2 looks really, really good on DraftKings. Chris Paul and Gildas Alexander, yeah, most of the stuff looks the same. Westbrook looks shithouse at 8,900. And you got Bazley at 39, probably less appealing for Baz over on DraftKings than he is over on FanDuel. That'll do it for me today, guys, with the two games on Wednesday. Don't forget, subscribe, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Stitcher, Spotify, and on YouTube. Leave a comment, give a thumbs up, subscribe, tell your friends. Guys, we are done here. Thank you so much for listening, everyone. See ya.